So this here is a technical drawing that we've drafted up to help us make this part. This is the instructions. It's the manual to your Lego kit. This here is a part of our lower trailing arm bracket for the rear suspension of the new solar car. This aluminium alloy is stronger than steel, and it's going to keep us safe and racing fast.
In this car, the solar panels, there's 4 square meters of solar panels which power the electric motor.
Robin is in charge of the mechanical part of the technical team. So he's our mechanical lead, and that means that he essentially is responsible for the entire shape of the car, the suspension, the wheels, the steering. And Aidan is a part of Robin's team, and Aidan's been one of the longest members on our team ever, actually. And he actually came to the ANU because he heard about our team.
I built some small model solar cars in high school. I really enjoyed it, loved the engineering project. And I thought, you know what, I wouldn't mind doing this full size, you know, racing someone from Darwin down to Adelaide. I mean, that's just great, isn't it?
I'm holding with me my steering wheel. It's currently disconnected from the car as we are transferring it to the new car, but this is basically where all the magic happens during the race.
David is in charge of the entire business side of our team. Getting our sponsors is not the responsibility of the uni, it's our responsibility. Like, if we don't organise our own sponsors, then we're not going to have any money to build a car. It's not a project that, you know, you just get things handed to you. It literally is not going to operate unless we have the business side of our team working really well. So it makes it a bit more like a little business than a project.
These are the battery cells that are in the battery, packaged up here for safety.
This is the battery that we put in our 2019 car.
The battery slides in this compartment here, opposite to where the driver sits, and that's to balance the weight distribution of the car.
When the sun goes behind a cloud, or we want to go a little bit faster to overtake, or something like that, we can draw on that battery power for a short period of time, or a little bit over a long period of time, to go a little bit faster. But obviously, we can't rely on that the entire 3,000 kilometer journey. The battery by itself would only last about 200, 250 kilometers.
I think that the team has a really good culture around it, so it means that you hang out with each other and you end up living with each other.
The people in the team are my friends. You know, we hang out on weekends. We're building solar cars during the week most times. But at the same time, you know, I've still got time for coursework. It doesn't take away from that. In fact, I'd say it enhances that. The things I'm learning in the classroom, I can go, all right, I'm going to apply that to this component.
And because there's only like-minded individuals on the team, you find that the people that are on the team are really people that are, you know, passionate and excited to learn in the same way that you are, and so it makes them really easy people to be friends with.